Wayward spirit beckons. I shall name you Foundling, and you may call me Sesta Janessa. You're uninitiated in the Revered's mysteries, I see. What a curiosity you are, wearing a mask like a shell. You've awakened him, but you know nothing of him yet. Fetch me one of his mementos, and some tar too. And I'm sure we can stir up some recollections. Of course, first you must find his name.
Ema Manrikea Mati Noter Zothrak.
Brigands pointed us toward the temple. Shunned by the devout, their allegiances lie to those who are fatah, or spirits. They entertain themselves with drunken antics or violent cruelties. They know better than to attack us. But they followed us at a distance, hoping for scraps.
It's been so long since anyone raised a hand toward me in kindness. You seem different, untouched by false truths. Unfortunately, I have little to offer you, save for that tarnished seal in your hands. A small gift, but I expect you will find it useful. Would you grant me another favor? Deep within the temples of the devout, you'll find the sacred glands of the revered. Bring the glands back to me, so I can extract the true nectar. Just enough to heal me. Perhaps you too can use it to free yourself from this wretched land, before you end up like me.
Yes, taste the truth. I have no desire to initiate the unwilling. Sip this, and you'll see.
Existence is a curious matter. The greatest triumph in the universe, gifted and squandered. I shan't make the same mistakes as my brother. When the moment comes, I'll exercise restraint.
The entrance is not far, Foundling. But you may regret trespassing. I speak not only of my brothers and sisters, but of their twins. Just as every flame casts a shadow, so too does the spirit. And here they manifest. Reflections, birthed from a broken mirror, a shattered place. Best not to burden yourself with such thoughts. Don't overindulge.
Yeah.
eager for another taste, foundling. Not so hasty. Not all places are as friendly as Fulgrim. There won't be any merriment around a bonfire here. Only the dead call this place home. All that remains are scavengers gnawing on bones. An intruder like yourself will not be welcome. So then, would you like another sip?
They foretold a truth more terrifying than any other. Those who glimpse it behold no monster other than an utter lack of meaning. The visage of a razor-thin line between existence and non-existence, and nothing in between.
You killed the Grisha. Many died dragging that beast down here. He served as a slave, a guardian, that they would worship unfettered, enshrined in ice. Can you blame them? The perversity of living has always been its ever-changing nature. So, then, would you like another sip?
With the tar throbbing in my belly, I see her completely. Each movement creates a swarm of copies. They ripple out from her, following their own whims. Some collide and join together, while others split apart, forming new copies. A reflection of reflections spreading out from her. The Nexus, yet also indistinguishable.
Do you feel them? The enshrined weight, watching the Immaculate for thousands of years. They will not stir until the Ascension. They wait for her to deliver them. Here, drink fully. Warm your bones. I see. sacred glare. Truly, you're blessed, foundling. That gland contains the true nectar, the most precious sacrament. Each drop holds both transcendence and transfigurement. Rare is the soul brave enough to extract such an offering. I'm afraid I'm no longer fit for such work. The rite of extraction requires deeply pious hands. Though perhaps deeply blasphemous hands would do.
Thank you.
taste what remains of their precious offerings. You must endure another temple, arduous though it may be. Once you return with another sacred land, I will infuse your tarnished seal with another gift.
Sip this.
The sacred rites remain closed to me. I'm unworthy of the venerated nectar. But I will prove myself. These sniveling rats who bow and scrape will never be enshrined. They have neither the will nor the strength to accept the deathless doctrine.
You've kept me waiting, Foundling. Do not worry. 'Tis only a jest. This path ahead is littered with monuments to suffering. Thought I might lighten the mood. Not that I've ever had much talent for humor. I once knew a man who took the Sacrament of Ashes. He laughed all the time. Now I'm rambling like an old crone. You're here for another sip, aren't you? Thank you. Yes. Slowly. You look parched. Such burdens are discarded in these chambers. Unless you... Can I tell you a secret, foundling? The body is a tainted vessel fraught with impurities. I do not miss it. Well, perhaps if you discard who pleasures of the flesh. I once thought we were alike. These disciples of mine, wayward soul, consecrated by ragged edge and raging flame. They seek only to be one with their immortal god. I pray that you do not find yourself upon the pyre. Don't overindulge. sip this. Sip this. Thank you. Yes.
Claimed I was unfit and impure, but I couldn't focus on the verdict. Beneath the shadow of the Immaculate, I felt no pain. I swelled with pride as my eyes beheld her inscrutable form. She was the last remnant of an unquestionable grace, lost eons ago.
Thank you.
Don't, Frith. It is not your mind unraveling, but our world. Us to believe our surroundings are immutable, even knowable. But nothing is certain within the sanctum of the revered. A curious blessing. My old kin do not shy away from these troubling inconsistencies. Instead, they welcome and embrace them. They worship at the feet of those rapturously twisted and reborn. So, calm yourself, and take a sip. Once I was in awe of the knowledge contained here. But it was a fool's errand to try to catalog the contents of this library. The devout keep searching, endlessly hunting for a revelation, even as they're surrounded by madness. Keep your eyes ahead, foundling. Do not stray among the teetering stacks. You'll only delay the inevitable.
Thank you.
Yes, you've done it. The sacred gland is yours. Perhaps it was always yours. If you manage to extract the true nectar, be wary. Sip slowly. I remember a heretic who drank deeply. He took what wasn't his and gulped it down greedily. He was unrecognizable afterward. Another man entirely. This was his reward and his penance. slowly.
Stay back. I will not waste this divine gift. Ah. Yes. I feel my wings unfolding, body burgeoning, eyes opening as if for the first time. So, this is how it feels to be chosen to reign above the rabble. Pitiful maggot. Bowing and scraping before their gods, their lives unraveling one thread at a time into a pile of utter meaninglessness. Fate favors those who act, be it in their own self-interest or otherwise. Come forth and bear witness to my ascension. Bask in my grandeur. It's time. It's all wrong. The visions have dissolved. the threshold.